नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर म्यूजिक क्लास। दिस क्लास इज फॉर क्लास 3। सो आई होप यू हैव एंजॉयड लॉन्ग ब्रेक मीन्स लॉन्ग वेकेशन ऑफ दुर्गा पूजा, दिवाली एंड देन यू हैड योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम पार्ट 3। एंड आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव स्कोर्ड वेरी गुड इन हाफ ईयरली एंड you are staying safe and healthy. So today we are going to start our revision theory syllabus. This time for our annual exam we will be preparing ourselves for with the theory part that I have already done, but this is a revision video. So in my previous video I have done description of ragas, so here also I am going to revise the description of rag yaman only. So first point that comes in the description, when you will be asked to write the description of rag yaman, what you have to learn, what you have to write, here are the points mentioned. First you have to mention the point thaat. What does thaat mean? In my earlier video also I have told that thaat is the frame or the structure of a rag. It's like a photo. A photo is framed. Without a frame, a photo cannot be hanged in the wall. So it's like a photo. So a rag cannot be sung. A rag cannot be a rag cannot be identified without a thaat. So the thaat gives the identity to the rag or the frame or the structure. So for rag yaman, the thaat is kalyan. Rag yaman is based on kalyan thaat. Next, jati. Jati means how many notes are used in the raga. There are 7 notes we know: sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha and ni. If all these 7 notes are used in a rag, then it is called sampurna raga. If any one note is skipped, then it is called shadav. And if any 2 notes are skipped, means 5 notes are used, then it is called adav. So if we count the aro-avro, we will be able to know that how many notes are used in this particular rag. Ni, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa. So at the beginning we are starting with the ni, and here one more ni is there. So ni will be counted for one time only. This is the repetition of the first ni. So ni we will not count for the second time. So how many notes are there? Ni, re, ga, ma, pa, dha. Again ni is there. That's why it will not be counted. Ni and sa. So 7 notes are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the repetition of this ni, so this will not be counted again, and sa. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All the 7 notes are used in aro and avro both. So the jati of this rag is sampurn sampurn. Next, vadi. Vadi means the main swar of the raga. The raga is identified by focusing on these 2 notes, vadi and samvadi. This is the most important swar of the raga and this is the next important swar of this rag. Vadi is ga and samvadi is ni, and every rag has got a particular time of singing because of its swaras, arrangement of swaras. The mood of this swaras particularizes or fixes up the time for this rag. So for rag yaman, the time is evening. means 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. So, I'm ending the video here. In my next video, we will be revising one more raga which is there in the syllabus of class 3. Up to that, you people just enjoy your music class and enjoy learning music. Namah Shivaya.